Today I'm flying out in the ILTU Stumovic, in ILTU Stumovic, using the HTC Vive, which has just had support added along with the Oculus Rift. We'll be attacking a supply train in German lines in what is probably the most complete VR combat flights that I've played it. For once, I don't feel disadvantaged by the low resolution of the headset. In fact, the game employs quite an effective model enlargement system to help mitigate the problems, allowing you to see targets at distance, even though the all experiences in a lower resolution than you normally would have. In fact, the whole game lends itself quite well to VR thanks to the bullet trails, smoke, and slower speed of combat compared to, say, DCS, where you're always engaging targets at a great distance. It really does give you a good sense of presence and feeling, being right up there in the mix of it. But anyway, let's cut to some combat. Looks like they got flat now. And somewhere up ahead there's a train waiting for me. I'm more or less at the attack point now. So just gotta spot that train. Oh, there you go. There's a train of smoke up ahead. I think there was an aeroplane out there too. Black dot. Yeah, there's an aircraft out there. Alright. Visibility is horrible in this plane. Flat going off around us. That's gotta be the train. That's not good. Right, let's get him for the train. Don't have any of those here. No, it doesn't look like it. And there's a AA gun having a go at me. Can't identify those two.
I think I've got someone chasing me. It's flying on the train again. Looks like wingmen are attacking. There's gorgeous plumes of smoke coming down on it. Let's line up for my run. Someone's chasing me. Rockets away. It looks like the locomotive has escaped.
Pretty sure someone's on our tail. The locomotive's gone through. Got a fighter on the tail. So we'll have a scrap at that train. There we go. It's more like it. I'll forget the cargo in a moment. I hope that fighter doesn't get us. Oops. I'm running out of air speed.
That's a tree.
Some gun down there. Got a few more bombs on it. He's on fire. Tell from the sisters. So the train's in pieces, to be honest. That's a Stanovic. It's a 109. Let's see if we can't catch him. Finish him off. Gonna have another go at him now. He's dead at any rate.
Ah, what was that?
That That's an Italian.
Just have to follow him and hope my escort can catch him. This is too fast for me.
Look, there's one of our escorts following him. Still a few carriages in one piece back there. Let's see if I can't finish them. Ooh, tree. Ooh, I picked up a few holes. Alright, that's my ammo spent. Tommy added back ammo, I think. Ooh. It looks like we're taking fire from a... what is that, a convoy? Ooh. Chris is getting a little bit close. So we're most of the way back home now. Just crossing over the front line, and I think we just got hit by their AA. Yep, we're taking this. Let's try and dive a bit. Stay out of the reach of their guns. I don't see any more traces, so I think we're past the worst of them. No, I don't see any more serious damage anyway. Uh-oh. I do believe I just ran out of fuel. That's unfortunate. See if she'll start again. Doesn't look like it. This could be messy. Hope I can make that clearing. Well, I'm done in one piece, I guess.
Well, it looks like I ran out of fuel. I was only about 10 kilometers away from the airbase. Well, with that, I'm honestly quite impressed with the VR in Altistomovic. It works really well, the performance is pretty good. And it does add a huge amount to the game whilst not feeling like I'm disadvantaged, thanks to the low resolution. And the immersion you gain from the head tracking in more precision, and in fact you have to look down the gun sight with your dominant eye or close one eye to see properly. There's a whole bunch of little things you don't really realise, including just how much hard work it is shifting your head around to look about the cockpit, especially in a dogfight. But with that, thank you for watching.